I'm James Vanderbilt. I'm the co-writer and producer of Scream.
I'm Guy Busick. I'm the other co-writer. I saw a Scream opening night in 1996 in December. I saw it with my friend Mark, and it was just an electric crowd. And I remember that as we were walking back to the car after leaving the theater, we were already quoting Billy and Stu lines. You know, my mom and dad are gonna be so mad at me. So it just immediately lit up, you know, our love of the genre, and you know, it was a really fun night.
The idea that we would get to write a Scream movie, and then I Guy, who I've known, and I knew when Scream came out, we've known each other that long, I knew how much he loved it too, and I sort of felt like I really wanted to take it on with a friend and someone I could trust, and who it meant as much to him as it did to me, and so I called Guy up and fooled him into doing this with me.
I wanted to see the story keep going, and I knew that Jamie and I would approach it with love. And respect, and that we loved those movies so much, and had talked about them for so many years. I think I felt we would hold each other accountable to not screw it up.
Yes. I do remember going to the first time Guy and I went and sat down and pitched him what we wanted to do is one of the most surreal kind of, sitting down and looking, sitting across from Kevin Williamson and telling him what you think Sidney Prescott is up to is one of the most surreal moments of my career.
Very surreal. One thing that was really important to both of us was we wanted to give those actors something new to play.
Yeah.
We wanted the characters to be in a very different place than the audience had ever seen them in, because that was the hope, was to get all three of them back.
Yeah.
And we wanted to give them something fun and new. And when Kevin weighed in on like where we saw the three characters, and you know, very favorably, that we kind of very visibly probably relaxed and went, okay, we're off to a good start. Now let's get into the story and like, who's the killer and what are the set pieces? And it was just so fun and exciting and as Jamie said, very surreal. I would have been far less comfortable being a part of this project if Jamie hadn't been involved and we hadn't had Kevin Williamson's blessing. I would have been very worried about this movie if we hadn't gotten Radio Silence, because in my mind, since Wes Craven is no longer with us, it is such a specific tone that he captures in those movies, and I don't see it a lot. And I was so influenced by Kevin's writing and Wes's direction. This is a horror movie, but it's fun and it's funny, and with characters hopefully you care about. And I knew Radio Silence could do it. This new Scream movie follows a young woman named Samantha Carpenter, and she's a Woodsboro native, but left 5 years ago, leaving her sister with kind of a neglectful parent. And she left under not the best circumstances, and she's still a little bit troubled, and we sense that there's something very dark in her past that she has yet to deal with. And then her younger sister, Tara, is attacked by someone in a ghost face costume, and that is the catalyst to bring Samantha back to town. And then we introduce the new friend group, which are Tara's high school friends. And generally, those characters in these movies are suspects, and so we start to point fingers, and the characters start to point fingers at each other, just like in every other Scream. And then, little by little, our legacy cast is drawn back into the mystery for various reasons.
There is a very specific fun to Scream movies that doesn't really exist as much in other slashers. There's a sort of an exuberance and kind of a joy for the genre in a way. And I feel like there have been so many great horror movies in the last 10 years, but this particular flavor to me feels like it's been missing. And so I think that they're really going to respond to. I think our young cast is incredible. I think we've gotten a group of actors together who are all going to have amazing careers. There's so much great work being done by all of them, and I think people are really going to respond to that. And I just think they're going to love spending time with the legacy characters. It's, you know, it's like seeing an old friend.